Hey guys, what's up? It's Joe Rady from Rady's Rides, and I am at the Motorsports by Reeves Gathering. It's a once a month event here at Tampa, Florida. Sun's coming up, walking around the show. Great bunch of cars today, and I came across, I know, one of my personal favorites, but also one of your personal favorites, a Subaru WRX. This is a 2013 Subaru WRX. We're gonna do something a little different this video. In 2008, Subaru did something that shocked the world. They came out with a hatchback STI. That was the only option you had. The WRX looked a lot different than the one you're looking at here. It was much more narrow. People were let down. People were disappointed. I think there were people like rioting in certain countries. It was crazy. Well, eventually Subaru decided, listen, we need to do something. So what they did was they brought back the sedan as an STI, as an option, and they went full wide fender for both the WRX and the STI. So if you look at this 2013 WRX, you can see the styling here. I like what they did with going a little wider. I don't know if Tom could show you. I like on a silver, especially with this kind of light, you can see how that fender is flared out. Very, very nice touch. It gives it that rally car look. To be honest with you, I think they went a little bit in the wrong direction. I think they made the WRX and the STI look too similar. And the problem with that is that when you ask, you know, a price tag of an additional $10,000 or so, that person with the STI wants to stand out a little bit more than maybe your average WRX. But I like the way that they took the similar styling down here with the fog lamps. Then you can get an optional STI lower lip spoiler, which I think would work wonders on the front of this car. It gives it just a little bit of an aggressive look to it. Also functional as well. I like what Subaru was doing with the open grille space here. And there's that beautiful Subaru emblem with the five stars. Remember, originally Subaru was part of Fuji Heavy Industries, and those, each of those stars, which are referenced from an actual constellation, were part of that Fuji Heavy Industries organization. There's that very famous hood scoop. It's there for a reason. It's not for show and no go. That is a top mount intercooler. So underneath the hood, you're gonna have that flat four turbocharged engine. Instead of the intercooler being down low, they place it right up top, because with a flat four, you actually have more room underneath that hood, and that's what is feeding that air into that intercooler. Let's go ahead and take a look at the side of the car. Now, what I like on this one is I like the wheels that this particular owner went with. It was a work style wheel. You can see very, very nice finish. I like how it really is working well with the silver. Very great quality. You could see in the back the red painted caliper. Now, I know a lot of times people say, oh, it's red, it's not doing any performance, but it gives it a nice little extra look, and that's a nice thing to see on a silver car. Really makes it pop. Let's work our way to the back. So this, like I said, being a sedan, you had an option. You had an option between the hatchback, and then you had an option between the sedan. But you could see that for this year, they decided to go with the styling. One thing that I'm not really in love with is going to be the chrome trim that they have here, but it is what it is. I'm just glad that they gave people an option, and that's the whole thing. You know, people say manual, people say dual clutch transmission. It's nice to have options at least. And then to wrap it off the back, you can see just how clean the look is. One thing I really like what they did with the back of the car is I like the revised rear section. I like how they went with the quad exhaust, and I really, really like how this particular owner put the carbon fiber trim here. One thing I would probably want to add is to go with the carbon fiber trim is maybe just a little kick-up spoiler. Nothing too crazy. You know, there's a lot of people that have WRXs and they want to put an STI wing, and I know that's sacrilege and all that kind of stuff. People burn things about that. But just a little bit of a, I think, of a kick-up spoiler here would just kind of just round off the whole back. But I really, really am liking the silver on this car. But this was an option. What we're going to do now is we're going to go and find, I don't know if it's possible, but we're gonna see if we could find a silver hatchback WRX so we could see the differences. Let's go check it out. All right, guys, so I was walking around, and lo and behold, could you believe it? I came across another 2013 WRX finished in the same silver, this one a hatchback. So as you could see, like I was showing you the other one, the styling from the front, they went a little bit different direction. They went a little wider. Now this one's a little different. Right off the bat, this one does not have those fog lights that the sedan had. That's something that was an option that you could have on either the hatchback or the sedan. But there's that same styling. I like, what I like on this particular one is that they left the, they put a nice WRX emblem there, and instead of taking it off like on the other one. Very, very clean. it gives it that rally car look to it, and that's what I love about the WRX and the STI. Let's go ahead and work our way down the side. This particular one has stock wheels. So if you remember, the other one had works wheels. That's something that the owner modified. This has the stock wheel. It's a really, really great, aggressive looking wheel. It matches well with the silver, and it's tastefully done. I'm telling you, if you would have seen like a 2008 or 2009 WRX, they missed the mark on that particular one. But I'm glad that they kind of regained that momentum with the 2013. Walking our way down the side. Now, here's something interesting. If you notice on the sedan, there was a chrome strip that ran across the bottom here, whereas on this one, it's just black. Why did they add that chrome strip? They should have just left it black like this hatchback. It really just allows it to blend in a lot better. As we work our way to the back, you can see that this one has a rear deck lid spoiler, and then out back, you got that same dual exhaust. Now, this one, the rear bumper cover is different. So you can see how, compared to the sedan, you're gonna get actually a totally different rear bumper cover, which gives it a different look, which is what I like. The difference between a hatchback and a sedan. You're still getting that same great all-wheel drive. You're still getting that same turbocharged flat four engine. It's just you need to decide, do you want the usability of a hatchback and the look of a hatchback, or are you more into that sedan look? And that is nice because they gave us options. I know when they came out with the 2015 WRX and STI, you don't have any options. Sedan it is. We will see for 2020, will they go back and bring back the choices like they had back then? But anyways, if these are the types of cars that you like to see on Rady's Rides, leave a comment in that comment section. Make sure you check out my Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram pages. All Rady's Rides original content all the time. If you have been a subscriber, thank you. Thank you so much for being on this journey. I'm so grateful for all the support, the great comments. It really is, we're building a community here. We're building a family, and it just keeps getting bigger and bigger. Especially how it just reaches across the world. If you are not a subscriber, what are you waiting for? Hit that subscribe button, join the journey with me. We're going one way, and that way is up. You'll love it. Each and every day I have daily uploads, and we feature some really great quality cars. Can't forget Big Guns McGee, my affectionate name for him, Thomas Moschner, the myth, the man, the legend, working out every day for his big day in December, powerlifting competition. Definitely want to give a shout out to him. Leave some love for Tom. You know, Tom looks through the comments. He sees the great comments we're getting for the channel overall. Leave some love for Tom as well, because I'm telling you, he's putting the work in and day out. Sometimes he goes home and he just practices filming just to make sure that he knows every single, I'm sorry, I have to laugh. He practices filming every single day so that he could get the awesome shots. And it shows. You guys see it. This guy's not a professional by trade, but I'm telling you, somebody needs to hire him real quick. And I'm hoping that it will be me once the channel really, really blows up. If you have not gotten yourself a Rady's Ride shirt, that's a great way to share the love and support the channel. They're 15 bucks. Right on that YouTube main page for Rady's Rides, click that About tab, lower left-hand corner, click the link right to Bonfire. They're 15 bucks. Get one for every member of your family, including cats and dogs. They do love the softness of the shirt. And just like always, guys, I'll see you on the next ride.